Hello friends. In this video, I will teach you how to create 3D environments and buildings in Moho. If we look at the project with the orbit tool, you can see that I created the buildings in 3D. First, I create a new work page through File and New. I press the Control button and G on the keyboard to activate the grid for me. I draw a rectangle with the Shape tool. I hit Control and G again and disable the grid. You can see that both Fill and Stroke are active for this rectangle. I choose the color of coffee for the building. Again with the Shape tool, I create a rectangle for the upper part of the window. I will put it in the right place. I choose gray color for it. I get a copy of it by pressing Ctrl C and Ctrl V. And I consider this copy for the bottom of the window. And I draw the window with the rectangle tool. With some other rectangles, I create the window glass. I change the color of the glass. Yellow color can be suitable. Now I select the entire window with the Select Point tool. I get a copy of it by pressing Ctrl C and Ctrl V. I repeat this and get several copies of the window. Adjust the location of the window so that the distance between them is the same. With the Shape tool, I draw another rectangle as the distance between the floors of the building. I will modify the points a little. I'm going to make a copy of the same one again and drag it a little lower. And I make it darker. Now I select all the windows and copy them and use them to make the windows of the lower floors. I move them down by holding the Shift button. By pressing Ctrl C and Ctrl V again, I get a copy of the windows for the lower floor. I select the two middle windows and delete them with the Delete button to draw a door for the building. I draw a rectangle as a door with the Shape tool. I put the door in the middle of the building. I make a copy of the door and make it smaller by holding the Alt key. I also create a rectangle for the door handle and change its color. I also darken the color of the edges of the door. Now you can see that we design the front of the building. I name this layer front. I take a duplicate of this layer. I will name it L, which means left view. I will make a duplicate of this layer again. And I will name it R for the right view. Now we have to put the origin on the left side of the building. I click on the L layer. With the selection tool, I select a point on the left side of the building. I select the transform tool. I copy the X position number and then select the origin tool and paste that number into the X axis of the origin. You can see that the origin is placed on the side edge of the building. I select all the points of the left layer with the select tool and drag it with the transform tool while holding the shift button. I put the edge of the two facades on top of each other. I delete the door in the left view with the delete button. And I copy and replace from the windows above. Now I select all the points of the left view. I select the rotate tool and write -90 on the y-axis and click on the scene. You can see that we created the left view correctly. You can reduce the number of windows in the left view. Now select the R layer to create the right view. I select one of the points on the right and copy the number of the x-axis. I select the origin tool and paste it on the x-axis. You can see that the origin is moved to the right side of the building. I select all the points and drag them to the right. I put the edges of the two facades on top of each other. I delete the door again and replace it with two windows by copying. I select the rotate tool and write the number 90 on its y-axis. You can see that the 3D building is now created. But there is a problem, and that is that the left and right views are combined with the front view, which we need to fix. I select three layers and put them in a group with right click. I double-click on the group layer and activate these two options in the depth sort section. I press the OK button. Now you can see that this problem is solved and the building is created correctly. I return to the front view and take a duplicate from the group layer. I change its location with the transform tool. In this way, we created a second building. I take another duplicate and create the third building. There is another problem that the buildings are combined from the side view. To fix it, I select three group layers and put them inside another group layer. I double-click on the new group and activate these two options in the depth sort section. In this way, this problem is also solved. I make the size of the building a little taller with the transform tool and the alt button. I can change their location with the transfer tool. With this method, we can create many buildings of different sizes. I create a vector layer and draw a terrain with the shape tool. Select the rotate tool and write its x-axis as 90. Now, with the transform tool, I bring the ground a little lower and put it in the right place. In this way, we also created land. You can add anything else to the scene. Thank you for being with me until the end of this tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Bye until the next video.